He who formed the eye, does he not see? Our focus was the stone, as we meditated on the theme, a stone's throw. You may recall that the stone is to remind you of two things: that we are all sinners, equally guilty before the holy God and deserving of death, and number two, that even the Holy Son of God chose not to pick up the stone and throw it at us. Rather, because of his love for us, he chose to bear all the punishment of our sin through the death on the cross. Today, the object of our costume play is the money bag. Our theme, based on the reading for today, is what is your price? What is your price? And that's the question we need to ask ourselves. There's an old saying, everyone has his price. How does that fit into our lives? How much would someone have to pay us in order for us to commit a sin? What would someone have to do or say to get us to do something we know God says is wrong? Can we be persuaded to give in to sin? What is our price? Is it high? Or is it low? We would like to think of ourselves as being spiritually strong enough to resist most temptations, and yet on its course. It could be called the price of murder, for that's what it costs to convince an unjust sentence of death on Jesus. It could be called the price of greed, for that's what it led Judas to say, "What will you give me?" Vengeance, hatred, murder, greed. What difference does it make? They are all sin. This money bag represents sin. But 30 pieces of silver is really not the price of sin. When Judas betrayed Jesus, his guilty conscience began to torment him. And he threw down that money there before the chief priests in the temple. But paying back the price of sin did not relieve his conscience or undo his sin. Jesus was betrayed. He was already condemned to sin and condemned to death, and on his way to the cross, Judas had a conscience filled with guilt that could not be healed by anything he tried to do. What a lesson to be learned from Judas. How different sin looks before and after it is committed. Judas was eager to sin, in anticipation of 30 pieces of silver. But after his sin, all the pleasure was gone. Before sin is committed, Satan holds out that lure of delight, happiness, and takes both fear and shame out of our hearts. But after the sin is committed, Each of us needs to take the good look at ourselves and all those little sins we committed. And we didn't even have to be offered 30 pieces of silver. We sin knowingly. We sin willingly. We sin freely. A little gossip here. A little tax cheating there. A couple of swear words once in a while. Oh, an occasional Sunday miss. Nothing serious, just a little idolatry on the side as we give in to the temptation of, well, placing the weekend ahead of worship. A little hatred. A little lie. A little bit of this, a little bit of that. It's all very painless. And soon, Jesus is gone from our lives. And we don't even miss him. And we didn't even sell him for a price. We gave him away. What is our price? There is nothing we can do to change who we are or what we deserve. Nothing that we can do. Judas tried. He gave the money back, but the priest wouldn't take it. We can try to cover up our sins or undo them, but it just doesn't work. Good news of Lent is this, that we have already been bought back from Satan. The same Jesus whom we have betrayed by our sins has bought us back. The price for selling out Jesus may have been cheap, but Jesus' price for buying us back was Lord Jesus, prepare our hearts to enter a time of reflection. The season of Lent, recalling your suffering and death, is only the beginning, for it is surely your amazing love that remains at the forefront. Open our eyes to the significance of the cross as we receive the forgiveness you offered. There is no depth of sin too severe to acknowledge it, for your grace far surpasses our sin. In your name, to the Father's glory. Amen. Almighty and gracious Lord, pour out your Holy Spirit on your faithful people. Keep us steadfast in your grace and truth. Protect and deliver us in times of temptation. Defend us against all enemies, and grant to your church your saving grace. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Taught by our Lord, and trusting his promises, we are bold to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And lead us not into temptation,
but deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom.